a left-leaning journalist decided to write a blog post about it. And he said, well, this is a bit much, this is a bit extreme to compare Obama to Castro. And a bunch of lefty commentators began putting comments going more and more hyperventilated about how dare you compare Obama to Castro. And so I'm sitting at about 1:30 in the morning, I'm reading the comments. And I did something I'd never done before, never done since, which is I signed on in my own name to respond to them. And I said, you know, I'm reading all of these hysterical comments about my father's speech, which I had posted on Facebook. And I said, I just want to make one point. If you look back at what my father said, he never once mentioned the words Barack Obama. Now, what does it say about you that you hear what Fidel Castro did and you think that's got to be Barack Obama?
It was exhilarating. But let's go back a little earlier, when he was 9 years old. That was 1980. He had just turned nine. And I had just become involved in an organization called the Religious Roundtable, which was a Judeo-Christian organization that worked hand-in-hand with a Virginian organization called Moral Majority that Jerry Falwell funded. And so, those two organizations working together, we mobilized millions of Christians across America to help elect whom I consider the greatest president since Abraham Lincoln, President Ronald Reagan. Woo! And so, all during that year of 1980, Ted was 9 years old, our conversation around the dinner table was about why we had to get rid of this socialist, progressive Jimmy Carter and replace him with a Christian constitutional conservative like Ronald Reagan. So every day for a year, when Ted was 9 years old, he got a dose of conservative politics from a Christian worldview. But I'll tell you, the one thing that really marked the rest of his life, when he was 13, just entering high school, through a client of ours, we introduced him to a man by the name of Roland Story. Roland Story was the president of an organization called the Free Enterprise Institute. So this kid is now just 13. He's reading Adam Smith and John Locke and von Mises and Hayek and Bastiat and Montesquieu and the Federalist Papers and the Anti-Federalist Papers and Milton Friedman. 13 years old. And then this organization creates a group of five kids. They call them the Constitutional Corroborators. What a name. They hired a memory expert and they taught these five kids, that was one of those, how to memorize the entire US Constitution. They used what was called a mnemonic device where they would memorize a string of letters and recreate the text from those letters. By the way, you can still do that today. So anyway, during the next 4 years, they traveled the state of Texas. They would come to a luncheon meeting, typically Rotary clubs. And while people were having lunch, they would put five easels in the front of the room. I gotta tell you this, I told that story to the group, a bunch of homeschoolers. None of those kids knew what an easel was. I had to tell, it's like a giant notepad with a tripod. But anyway, they would put five easels in the front of the room, and while people were having lunch, these kids would write the Constitution by memory, and then after lunch, proceed to give a half-hour patriotic speech on free market economics and the Constitution. During the next 4 years, my son Ted...